Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another Minecraft video. So today, we are obviously back on Aqua's Adventure, my single player world. And today we're going to be having lots of fun because I'm actually really excited about what we're going to be doing today. You can see kind of the little list behind me. First, we're going to go get some polar bears, and second, we are going to be building a parkour map. Now, the parkour map's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to have lava under it, and then we're going to run around, maybe with some valuable gear, maybe lose it, maybe not. We will see, but guys, today we're going to have a lot of fun, and let's get started. So guys, the first thing we're going to do is go get the polar bears. Now, you can't actually tame polar bears, and you can't really like attract them with any type of food, so you actually have to get them with leads. Now, I actually did some work before this episode. I actually found polar bears and trapped them in the ice spike biomes. All we have to do is drag them here. And the one thing I actually forgot to do is to make a place for them actually here. So for now, like I said, we're just going to go get the polar bears. We'll do something else with them in a later episode, but for now, we just want to go get them. So you know what I'm going to do? Let's just make a little place right here that we can put them in. And yeah, let's go into the nether and let's go get them. Okay, so we are here at the nether portal to go to the ice spiked. And you guys will see how I trapped the polar bears in a second. Yeah, so I actually got them, grouped them up, put them in here. I didn't bring them all the way back, but we will do that now. So here I have two adult polar bears, which is pretty cool. Now let's grab the leads. We can lead one. Lead the second, and let's try to bring them through. Will they come through? Okay. This is gonna be a little tougher than I thought. Oh no. I don't know. Come this way. Okay, come on. Get through here. Okay, it looks like this isn't. Oh, there goes one. Alright, let's bring the other. And there goes the next one. Alright, do we still have our leads? I'll see if we have our leads in a second. Now, please don't. No. Where are my leads? I don't know where my leads are. Okay, let's push them back. Okay, come on. Where are my leads? Okay, so I finally managed to get both polar bears and both leads with me. So let's grab both of them and let's take them to the base. Now, obviously, I'm not going to record me talking all the way because this is going to be a long, long journey. But yeah, guys, I'm just going to carry them over to the base, and I'll meet you guys there. Okay, guys, so I've managed to get both polar bears here. I actually had to install stairs on there to actually get them up. But yeah, we have both of them. Now let's try to put them into the nether, or out of the nether, into my base, obviously. There goes one, and there goes a second. So now what I got to do is once I get in, I have to pull both of them away from the nether portal. So you come this way. Alright, and you come this way. Come on. No, not there. Okay, and then let me take the lead off of you. No. Don't go back. If you go back into the nether, that's going to be a hard time getting you back. Okay, so you know what? Screw the leads. Bam, there. Alright, there we go. Now we have two polar bears in our base. That is amazing. We have two polar bears. And you know what? I'm just going to leave them there. In the next couple episodes, we might do something with them. But for now, yeah. I'm just going to keep them there, of course, so I don't lose them. But now, guys, we get into the more exciting project, in my opinion, and that is the parkour map. I've got that prepared also. I've been doing a lot of preparations before episodes now, but I think that's a good thing. It is soon going to be nighttime, but this is where the parkour map is going to be. So I dug three down. Obviously, the lava is going to be at the bottom, and I have a little list of things to do here with chests with all my materials and even maybe little setups. So let's go through each of them. Number one, I'm going to have to remove these things. So the beetroot farm and then the chorus plants. These are all going to have to be removed. Replace dirt with bone. So this entire thing is going to be made out of bone blocks. Add the parkour. Add the prizes at the end. Add the lava. And lastly, probably die a lot. So yeah, we have steps to go through. So for the first step is to remove the chorus plants. Now I'm pretty sure I still have some of the bulbs or whatever you call them, so we can just feel free and take them down. So let's just kind of go through all of them and take them all down. And of course we'll put grass in its place and we'll take the beetroot farm out. So yeah, today's episode is going to be kind of focused on this. So we're going to go through each step very in depth. Let's pick up all this chorus plant, fruit, whatever you call them. And then we'll have to go and pave our way through the beetroot also. And I do want to make sure I collect all this, because I still haven't built any kind of chorus farm or anything like that. So I do want to not waste any of this. Let's just grab all of it that we can get, because who knows what we might use it for. To be honest, it's not very useful. When you eat it, it just gives you food and it teleports you somewhere random. But yeah, next step is we have to remove all these little things, and we will put something here in this place, but obviously the chorus and the beetroot things are just temporary. We will make farms for both. You know what, I don't even care about the endstone, we have plenty of endstone. Let's just remove it like this. Yep, and then we'll go through. We have silk touched a lot of grass, so we'll go ahead and fill in some grass in there. And we do have to get rid of the beetroot water. I just thought about that, because I don't want to make a mess, obviously. Let's get rid of this one, and then, yep, there's all the water. And let's remove that, and let's just go ahead and plow through all this. I'm not even bother just picking it all up. I'm just going to go ahead and plow through all of it, and just get rid of it all. It'll still give us the beetroot and the beetroot seed, so it really doesn't matter to me. Let's just go ahead and go straight through it. This is awesome, seeing all these. Oh no, there's water. Oh no, I forgot about that one. Okay, let's block that one up. Hopefully that didn't destroy anything too important. And then destroy those. I guess we'll do that with my pick. Let's pick all this up. And I do have some chests here just for this occasion. So let's run over here. I think this top chest is my junk one. Yeah, this is my junk one, so we can just kind of throw everything in here. And let's go inside the house, grab some actual grass, because I could just put dirt here, but to be honest, I have... Oopsies, I'm stuck in a block. I do have grass silk touched, so there's no point in waiting. Might as well just put it down. We have plenty of it. So guys, real quick, I'm going to place it all down, and I'll be right back. Okay, so the next thing is to actually make this thing out of entirely bone. So I did actually run out of dirt, so when we go get bone, we'll also grab some more of this grass dirt. But yeah, let's just, I think I already took a bunch back at the chests. Yeah, actually I did take a bunch, so let's just head back over there, fill in the rest of this grass, and then grab some bone out of the chest. I already completely forgot that I actually did grab all the materials we're gonna need for this. I think all the lava's over there, all the bones over there, and I have some slabs. You know what, I was gonna fix this, but to be honest, we don't actually need to fix this, because all of this is gonna become bone anyway. So let's take off one more layer here. We're gonna take off one layer off each side and then add bone to it. Alright guys, let's grab all the bone in here and let's start putting it around the sides and make the floor out of it. Okay guys, so the entire wall is made out of bone block. Now I just realized that I was gonna make the floor out of bone block, but there's no reason to. This entire floor is actually gonna be covered in lava, so there's really no reason for me to do that. And by the way, when I went through the wall, I actually did have to go redo half the wall, because if you guys notice, the way you kind of put the block, there's two faces to the bone block. There's a part that's completely white, and there's a part with a kind of like a dark section. So this is how the wall actually looked like, with these dark patches. So I had to go and remove those and put and try to like flip them around the other way. So I actually did have to redo like half the wall, but that's completely fine. So let's go back over here where our jump boost is. And we still actually can't get out, so we just have to kind of place a block there. And let's go take a look at the next step and remove that block. Let's see what we have to do next. Oh, the best part is add the parkour. So guys, right now, obviously, this doesn't look very nice, but trust me, once we add the lava, all that ugliness down there is going to be gone, and then it'll look really cool, obviously, because right now it just kind of looks a little bit ugly. But yeah, next we have to add the parkour now. When I said I was building kind of like a parkour map, I didn't mean like go 100 feet in the air and do a bunch of sections. And of course, this is just a little place where we can just do some jumping and have some fun. So it's not going to be like super, super crazy amazing. But let's try to jump out of here. We will be adding kind of like basic jumps and have harder and harder jumps. You guys will see in the end, obviously. I think it's going to be very, very cool once it turns out. And I'll actually show you guys here what I have to do. See, I have to go from the sideways view like that. So obviously the big dark spots don't show up. But back here, if we look, I've kind of added something. So across each line, we'll kind of have, like, this is one block apart, and then two block apart, three block apart, four block apart, five blocks apart, and we'll end up having some maybe sideways jumps and going upwards and downwards. I don't think we'll go downwards very well, but, yeah, do I have slabs in here? I didn't bring slabs with me, I just brought a couple, but yeah, after we do that, of course, we'll add all the lava down there. But I'm actually gonna pick these up. You know what? Actually, I don't need to pick them up. I have probably more slabs, and yeah, we're gonna start building. Let's just grab those slabs real quick, because obviously, if we don't have those slabs, we can't do much of anything. I think they're in here. Yes, and that's actually a good amount of slabs. And if you're wondering why I'm using slabs, it's just because you can work with them so much. Well, not easier, because they're actually harder to work with, but they're only like half. You can have more precision jumps. Entire blocks will just kind of make it weird, but yeah, I guess we can just start on this side. So here, I guess we'll have it, because we needed at least one apart from this. The first one's gonna be one block apart, but of course, I'm gonna just do this. I'm just gonna bring it across, and then here, let me take these three out, and then one by one I'll just remove them. So let's have it all the way across. So let's just remove one in between all these, like so. So then we'll have one apart. Whoopsies. And then I gotta make sure not to try to break them. Then this one. So yeah, that'll be the one jump. And then we're gonna move one next to it. And we'll have like the two block here, three block here, four block, five block. And then let's see how many we can do. Okay, and that's actually a perfect odd number. That's a good thing, because I was about to get worried. Alright, so yeah, I'm just gonna bring them all the way across and do the same thing all the way up until the five. Okay guys, so the first five are done. Now I do want to add something that's kind of interesting about this. I'm just gonna add a step here. Is actually the five, it's not jumpable without the speed boost. So, or jump boost, my bad. Well, speed and jump boost. So you guys know we have the beacon. So I think the five can be made with the jump boost, but it cannot be made without it. So we can let the jump boost drain, because that's the cool part. Here, the jump boost doesn't reach all the way here, but it does on the other side. So yeah, with the five, we'll have to be careful not to go on. I think I can hit this one, because that's a, actually, I don't even know if I can hit that one. Can I even hit the four? We should actually check if we can even hit the four. With this one, I'll actually have to make a couple more steps. Let's see if we can even hit the four. So if we can't hit the four, then that'll be just another. Or maybe the four. Well, maybe we can't even hit the four. But yeah, we will be able to hit the four with the jump boost. So I'm still going to leave it in. But yeah, now we have to think of something else, obviously. Because now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like the block amount. Now we got to think of maybe a zigzag, maybe heights. So yeah, I'm going to get kind of working on that and we'll see. Well guys, after a good little bit, I have finished the entire kind of parkour jumps and stuff, and I'll kind of go through them. But one thing I do want to say is I literally thought of these on the spot. I did not make these up beforehand, so obviously some of these could be really easy or just extremely hard. And I know there's a mix of some that actually are impossible without jump boost, some that are possible without jump boost. So again, I'll have to be careful, and if I get stuck without jump boost in the middle of the map, well, that is my fault. I should have done it quicker. That's how I'm gonna think about it. I also added kind of a bonus level with fences, because I noticed that there's nothing with fences. And like I said, this isn't a very wide variety. This is just 1, 2, 3, 4 with height differences, with like block, whatever it's called, limitations on jumping, kind of strafe jumps, and little jumps. So obviously there's not such a big variety, but we can expand the map always, and I can add more things, and I can fix this as things go along. But the next thing is to add the prizes, but you know what? I really want to add the lava already just to make it look really cool. So, yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop off everything, actually, because I might die here. So I'm going to drop off everything. Let's grab the lava buckets. Let's grab as many as possible. And what I think I'm going to end up doing is I'm going to need a couple blocks on me, of course, just to get out. And, yeah, let's go ahead and place the lava. So I guess we'll start from one corner. I haven't really measured out how much I need. I kind of just grabbed a whole bunch of lava and hoping that it'll do enough. And if it isn't enough, I'll go grab some more. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it looks like between every single two. So 1, 1, 2, 1 here, 1, 2, 1 here, 1, 2, 1 here, 1, 2, 1 here. And then I think this will this spread all the way across? Okay, it will. So, how are we... Oh, no, the fences are on fire. I completely forgot about that. I'll have to actually replace these with another rack fences. But I'll do that after I place the lava, because why not? So you know what I'm going to do? I'm actually just going to start kind of spamming lava. I still have my diamond armor on. Okay, well, I'll have to just make sure not to die then. But yeah, I'm going to stop with the whole measuring thing. I'm just going to put it on. If I don't have enough, I'll go grab some more. But all I really need to make sure is that I cover almost everywhere. I don't need places where there aren't lava, you know? So place there, there, and hopefully that covers everything. If it doesn't, I'll go get more. But now there are stakes at hand. I have my gear on if I lose that. But actually, this gear protects me from lava really well. So I'm actually not that worried. So let's place that there. Let's burn up those blocks, because why not? And yeah, it does look like I'm not going to have enough, so I'll have to go get some more. Oh, got to be careful. Yeah, I've probably got about half this place covered. So I am going to go need to get more. I guess we'll just finish off the rest of these buckets, and then we'll start going to get more. Yeah, I'm not going to be even close. Alright, well, we got a good portion of it done. So guys, what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to go ahead, get some lava, fill this all up, and I'll be back once all of this is done. Okay guys, so there's a lot of things that have been done. Let me put my armor away just in case I somehow fall in. But yeah, I replaced the fences with these netherrack fences that cannot burn up. And I added all the lava, obviously, so I went to get a whole load of lava. And the entire thing is covered. And I think the whole thing of not being one straight lava of it actually flowing adds a lot to it. And I think it looks really, really cool. So now, the last thing we have to do. Where is my axe? I kind of want to replace things here. So I removed those, obviously. I replaced everything with bone. Added the parkour. Added the lava. And clearly, we're going to die a lot. So all we have to do is add the prizes. Okay, so how the prizes are going to work is, I guess I'll just give each of these kind of like a number, and then I'll have a chest with each of those numbers, and if I get a cross, I can get a prize out of it. I think that's how I'm going to do it. So give me a little bit of time to think about it and see how I'm going to set it up, and then I'll go ahead and do it. Okay guys, so how I'm going to do it is, if you make it from either there to here or from here to there, you just take a prize out of the chest that kind of corresponds with the row. So obviously this is row I, row H, row G, row F, E, D, C, B, and A. And then I'm going to put prizes in here kind of corresponding to maybe how hard it is or something like that. So yeah, real quickly, I'm going to put prizes, I'll be right back, and then I'll show you guys. Well guys, I have finished it up. I have placed prizes in all the chests. I'm actually pretty excited to show you guys the prizes. So each of these chests is filled with like different things. So every time you win, you get to take like kind of one slot. And obviously, at some point I just kind of guessed to put a bunch of stuff anywhere. But there are some more expensive stuff kind of in like this, and these rolls. Like these three are harder stuff. This is kind of hard. So let's just kind of go through each of them. The first one which is the easiest. Doesn't have much good stuff. It has a few potions, obsidian, and some magma blocks. Just not very, very special, because this obviously isn't that easy. Next one, and I'm not going to even explain, you guys can kind of just look through it. And this one I added some redstone parts that are kind of expensive, some blaze rods, some iron. Next one I added a sponge, maybe a good fishing rod, some more potions. And this one I added a pick, which is good, more magma blocks, some slime blocks, a diamond. In this one there's more diamonds, a good bow, some golden horse armor. In this one there's actually two things which are both pretty good, enchanted diamond gear, some diamonds. Yeah, that's kind of the most expensive stuff. Here's two more tools, some pistons, a name tag, a hopper, and of course a chorus flower. Here I put some more diamonds. This one's not as hard, so I didn't put very hard stuff. And last one, a lot of diamonds, some random rabbit hide, some obsidian, some slime balls. So those are kind of the prizes. Now, we built this entire thing. Now, of course, we do have to use it. So right now, I have nothing on me, and I guess we can just go through with it. If I die, I'm going to end up back in my house, but of course, I'm going to try not to die. So I guess we'll just kind of go through each of them, see how hard they are. So this one shouldn't be that hard. We could probably just jump through it. Now, of course, we got to remember, we do have jump boost, and we will run out of it, so we're going to have to kind of change our jumping patterns. But yeah, we can probably even actually jump two if we wanted to, but that was risky a little bit. So yeah, this one should be easy. The only way I can die in this one is if I make, like, a really newbie mistake. Oh, no, like that. See, that's the thing that throws you off. Now, my XP is gone. That does not make me happy, and I'm lagging a little bit. But, yeah, exactly when the jump wears off, you die, because that really confused me. I didn't know how far to jump, but I guess we can just kind of quickly jump through it, jump over multiple ones. Whoop. And then jump over multiple, land on this one, and I'm back into the lava. What? Guys, I can't even make it past literally the first level. Oh, this is, I'm never going to get those prizes, especially on the harder ones. What is this? Okay, you want, we're going to have to be really careful and go really fast. Or just be kind of careful overall. So jump, 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 jump. Just got to kind of do it rhythmically, jump. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, that was scary. Jump, 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 jump. Okay, we've made it past the first level. Now, we actually don't have jump boost, so now it's going to be a little bit different. Jump up. Okay, and I got to make sure not to lag. These are the two. Actually, I can just kind of run and jump. Oh, okay, and then we'll get our prizes after, guys. I don't want the prizes to burn up, obviously. So it looks like this one's a little bit easier than the one, I guess. I don't know why. Maybe that one was a little too short, but there's a second. Let's try to go for the third. Oh, okay. Bang, bang. Yeah, of course, we do have the jump boost. It's going to be... And we died anyway. It's going to be a little easier, I was going to say, until I fell straight into the lava. Let's head back out there. And you know what? Let's try the five, and then let's try some of the other ones. Yeah. Okay, let's run over to the five. And let's see, of course we have jump boost, so one. Oh no, I don't think it, oh, and actually I fell into the lava. I think with the five, we're gonna have to run without stopping. Because I think if we stop, we're gonna lose a block of like height or like speed. So I think we might actually have to just go straight through it without messing up. So yeah, let's try this. One, two, three, four, five, and bang, that was awesome. Okay, now for this one, we actually have to go to the other side, and same for this one. So let's real quickly kind of, I do have jump boost, so it's kind of cheap, but let's try the more one where we have to strafe up, and bang, that was awesome. Okay, let's try, how about this height one, because I think we do need, so we got to jump up there, and I missed, no. I know you can jump up there, because obviously when I built it, I made sure I could do it, but. Yeah, the lag. Sorry, guys, about the lag right when we die. Of course, I have to kind of render everything in again a little bit. But, yeah, let's go for that one. I know I can make that jump because I've done it before. Let's try to go. Oh, there we go. We kind of have to keep pushing. So now we got to make it all the way to this one. Then bang, bang. Oh, we have to go down low for that one. Come on. Okay, there we go. There we go. There we go. Now this is... Oh, I almost fell in, and that's... Oh no, I can't believe I missed that one. Out of all the ones, it's the little last one. We just have to kind of jump. Well, okay. I'm just gonna say I made that one, because I really should have, but I did miss it in the end. Now, let's lastly try the fence one. This one's probably gonna be the most difficult one, just to be honest. But let's try to... One, and then two. Oh no, and I fell in. Oh... Well, obviously, I'm not going to do these all episode, because you guys don't want to watch me parkour. You either want to do it yourself or something, and I've actually thought about releasing a world download at some point in time, and I might do that pretty soon, maybe a 100 episode special at episode 100. Tell me guys what you think about that if you do want it, but let's do this last one, and then we'll end off the episode. But yeah, this one, I know this one you can just jump over. This one was meant to... have you jump around it. So let's try that. So if we can jump around it like that. Alright, we made the first one. I don't know if we can do it for this one, but let's do it. And I fell in. Yeah. Okay, well, we're gonna do one thing real quick, because I wanna make this pricey. So we'll obviously collect our prizes, but we're gonna do something very, very dangerous with our prizes, because why not? Okay, render in, please. Okay, so we finished this one, so let's grab a block. We finished this one, let's grab a blaze rod, grab a piece of glass. Let's get, you know what, no, not this one. Let's grab this one, piece of obsidian. I'm pretty sure, yeah, okay, actually, we didn't finish this one, so let's put that back. We finished this one, let's grab a diamond. We didn't finish that one. We finished this one, let's grab, how about... crystal, and we didn't finish that one. All right, so these are our prizes at the moment. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go do this with the prizes. So you know what, I'm gonna go for this sword. So if I can finish this, I get the sword, and if I lose, obviously I lose all these items. So let's try to do it. Jump up. I made it. Oh no, and I fell in. Oh well, yep, there goes my items, and I sadly do not get the sword. Well, that was the price of doing it. I was going to get the sword, but I fell in like a dummy head. But yeah, guys, so I think this is going to be the end of the episode, sadly. So guys, I had a lot of fun building this. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching me build it and obviously fail at it quite a lot. So guys, thanks for watching. If you did enjoy it, make sure to like and comment as it supports my channel. And I'll see you guys later. God bless and goodbye.